हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी लर्न द पोएट्री इंडियन वीवर्स। इंडियन वीवर्स, दिस पोएट्री इज कंपोज बाय सरोजिनी नायडू। वी ऑल इंडियंस नो सरोजिनी नायडू जी एज अ पॉलिटिकल एक्टिविस्ट, फेमिनिस्ट एंड फर्स्ट इंडियन वुमन हु बिकेम द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस। शी वॉज important person in the freedom fight activities, and she also was a renowned poet, and she earned a title of the Nightingale because of her poetry work. Later she became the governor. This was about Sarojini ji. Now we'll read the poetry and try to explain it. See, I read the poetry. Listen, Indian weavers. Weavers weaving at break of a day, why do you weave a garment so gay, blue as the wings of a halcyon wild? We weave the robes of a newborn child. Here the poet Sarojini ji is asking to the weavers, Indian weavers, because this poetry is composed in context to Indian system. So the Indian weavers, this word is used deliberately here. She is asking to the Indian weavers that you people are weaving a very, very delicate, very, very beautiful cloth at the time of early morning, at the time of dawn. And the color of this cloth is blue, like the wings of wild halcyon, that is kingfisher. The viewers reply, see what they reply. They say, we weave the robes of a newborn child. We are weaving clothes for newborn child. So these clothes are so beautiful, soft and delicate. Here the life is beginning. A child has born. At the different stages of the life of human in India, they wear different clothes. There is a tradition. So they are saying that we are weaving clothes for a newborn child. See the next stanza. Weavers weaving at the fall of night, why do you weave a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green, we weave the marriage veil of a queen. She is asking to the weavers at the time of fall of night, at the time of dusk, there is no sun, but there is a little light. Day and night meets there. It is called dusk. That time, she is asking to the weavers, what are you weaving at this time? And why? What and why? You are weaving a cloth. It is so bright, so attractive. It is like the plumes of peacock. It is like the feather of peacock. That beautiful part of its feather that is blue and green, that looks so attractive. Why are weaving this cloth so attractive, so nice, so bright colored? The weavers reply. See what they reply? They say, we weave the marriage veil of a queen. They say that they are weaving a marriage veil. V-I-L, veil. For the queen. This is the second stage of a life in India. When a person meets to younghood, he becomes adult and he is married. And here the life starts. And here there are colors in life. Everywhere there is a beauty. Everywhere there is a prosperity. So that person who show love through the colors, the emotions that are shown through the colors of these clothes. So they are saying that they are weaving a marriage veil for a queen. See the third stanza. Weavers, weaving solemn and still, what do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as the feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. This is the third stage of human life. In India, when a person dies, the last cloth for him, that is a shroud. Indian language, kafan. Kafan kaha jata hai usse. Kafan, shroud, funeral, shroud. Wo safed rang ka hota hai, India mein. और उसका कोई रंग नहीं होता, बेजान कपड़ा. इंसान बेजान हो जाए तो कपड़ा क्या जान रखेगा. सो लाइफलेस कलर, कलरलेस क्लोथ दे आर वीविंग इन द चिल मूनलाइट. दे आर सॉलेम, दे हैव बिकम साइलेंट, दे आर वेरी वेरी सैड. फर्स्ट टू स्टेजेस दे वेर हैप्पी, फॉर द लाइफ केम इन द वर्ल्ड. They were happy. The life was prospering. The queen was going to marry. They were happy. But the last stage, when a person dies, nobody can be happy. Same thing is about weavers here. They are very sad. But they have to weave the cloth. And that cloth is called funeral shroud. And they are weaving the funeral shroud. In this poem, the poet tried to relate a weaver's work to the three stages in human life. That is birth, that is prosperity, that is growth, and the third one, the end of life, that is death. That is the poetry about the human life. Here, Sarojini ji has written a beautiful poetry. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much. Take care.